This video I'm going to take the battery I just modeled and change the pickup item to be that battery, so let's go ahead and do that now. So the first thing I need to do is right click in the content browser. I'm going to add a new folder. I'm going to call this assets, open it up, and then we want to drag in here the asset that we just created. And if you want to download this, there'll be a link in the blogs, go ahead and check it out. So I'm going to drag this and drop it in here. And then all these should be good. I'm just going to import. So now we've imported this, I'm just going to save all. So we can see we have the battery object. So even though it's created the materials, which we brought over from Blender, it's not kept the roughness or the metallic values. So I just need to change that. So I'm going to click on each one of these, start with a base, open this up. So we have this here and our color. So just like Blender, we have this shader, which we can change a whole bunch of options. Now we can't really change the options here. We have to add a new node and plug it in. So I'm going to add in a constant. So we can either right click and type constant and then click this. Or if we press the number one key and then left click, we can add a constant. So either way, you can add one of these in. Now I'm going to connect this one up to the metallic value and then do the same thing for the roughness. So for this one, I'm going to change this to a value of 1. This one, maybe 0.2. See how this looks. So it's not too bad, and we can always come back and make this look even better in the future. But for now, it looks a lot better than it originally was. Just save this. And close it down. Now I'm going to do the same thing for these two here. So now our battery pickup is ready to be used. So I'm going to go back to the blueprints section. Select the battery pickup blueprint, just open it up. Then if we go to the viewport, select the static mesh, and then from here, what we can do, we can just find the battery. Or if we close this down, go back to the content browser, back to the assets. If I select this, then go back to the blueprint, I can just select the arrow here, and there we go. So I'm gonna compile that, and let's see how it looks. The battery is far too big, so we can always scale this down. So let's select these and delete them. So it's too big, and also the box doesn't line up now, so let's go back. I want to select the box and I'm just going to reposition and then rescale it, something like this. Compile that, close this down. Now we can select this and scale it down. So we want this to be quite small, so even that might be too big since the character, you can see his hands are still smaller than the battery, so maybe we even scale this down a bit more. Maybe something like that. If we bring it over, we can sort of compare it. So it still might be a bit too big, but we don't want to make it too small because the player might not be able to see the battery pickup. So let's just put it all the way over here. Press play, see how it looks. So we see it's quite small. As we run over to it, it will pick up and then add to our battery. So now we can see it's disappeared since we've collected it. But now we actually have an object that is representing our pickups. So I thought I'd make this a separate video just because the last one was quite long and I didn't want to bore you guys to death. In part 3, when we create the HUD widget, when we collect these batteries, we'll make a counter go up so we'll know how many batteries we've got to use. It was a quick way to add the battery object. Again, if you want to download this, there'll be a link in the blog. Go ahead and do that. Or if you want to create your own, go ahead and do that too. So I hope this video helps, and I'll see you in part 3.